The equation for a line is y is equal mx plus b. Now, if the zeros and the ones here are linearly separable, then we want to obtain the equation of the line that separates them. This is why I renamed x1 and x2 from the previous tutorial to y and x. So we start by randomly initializing the weights, w1 and w2 in this case, and then we go into a loop where we first calculate the weighted sum. So ws is equal w1 times y plus w2 times x. Second, we apply an activation function, and in this case we are using a step function with the threshold equaling to 1. So if ws is bigger than 1, then the result would be 1, and if ws is smaller or equal to 1, then the result would be 0. Third, we determine the error. So the error is equal to the target result minus the result. And fourth, we adjust the weights. So W1 is equal to the learning rate times the error times Y plus the original W1. And W2 is equal to the learning rate times the error times X plus the original W2. And we repeat steps 1 through 4 for all vectors in the training data. And this would be one epoch. And we outer loop through additional epochs until the error is equal to 0 for all training vectors in the final epoch. Now the objective is to determine what weights, in this case what W1 and W2, would lead to the target result equaling to the result for all vectors in the training data. So we set WS equaling to the threshold. So W1 times Y plus W2 times X is equal to the threshold, and this lead to Y is equal minus W2 over W1 times X plus the threshold over W1. And since this was the equation of a line, then M is equal minus W2 over W1, and B is equal to the threshold over W1. This is a pre-built version of the application. So if I go ahead and run it, we obtain the equation of this line that separates those three zeros from this one. So Y is equal minus 0.53x plus 1.44, and 2 points on that line are x is equal to 0 and y is equal 1.44, and x is equal 2.70 and y is equal to 0. Next, I'll start by creating a new Java project. And here we need the full JDK. I have it set up in this directory. And we will need two classes. A driver class with a main method. And it will be in this package. And since this is a JavaFX application, it will extend from application. And by doing that, we add this method. And we also need a perceptron class, which is an artificial neuron modeling a biological one. And the code here will be mostly the same as in the previous neural networks tutorial that I have done. So I added this threshold constant and set it to 1. And this is the AND training data. So if we have 0 and 0 or 0 and 1 or 1 and 0, then the target result will be 0. If we have 1 and 1, then the target result will be 1. And for the purpose of this tutorial, I set the learning rate to be 0.05. And both W1 and W2 will be randomly initialized to a number between 0 and 1. And we have three methods. One to calculate the weighted sum. So the weighted sum is equal to W1 times Y plus W2 times X. And this method applies the activation function. So if the weighted sum is bigger than the threshold, then the result will be 1, otherwise the result will be 0. And the third method adjusts the weights and returns an array of adjusted weights. So W1 is equal to the learning rate times an error times y plus the original W1, and W2 is equal to the learning rate times the error times x plus the original W2. Now going to the driver class, we'll have two printing methods, one to print the heading, so W1 and W2, and the training data, and the actual result, and the error, and the weighted sum, and W1 and the adjusted W1 and W2. And this one, the print vector, would print the data under those headings. And in main, a call to launch will end up triggering a call to the start method. And let me define static M and static B in the equation of a line y is equal mx plus b. Now here we will first pick up the training data, and next we will pick up the initial W1 and W2, and we will instantiate a driver and a perceptron, and let's define an epoch number counter, and we will start it from 0, and we need an error flag, and initially it will be true, and an error, and we will initially set it to 0. And let's define an array of adjusted weights. Now while the error flag is true, we will print the heading for each epoch, and we will initialize the error flag to false and error to 0 before going into a loop that goes through the training data, where we would first pick up the weighted sum for each vector by calling the calculateWeightedSum method. And next we will apply the activation function on the weighted sum that we obtained here, and then we will pick up the error, which is the difference between the target result and the actual result, And if the error is different than 0, then we would set the error flag to true. Otherwise, the error flag would stay false, which means that we would exit this while loop. And next, we will pick up the adjusted weights by calling perceptron.adjustWeights. And we will call the print vector method. And set the weights to be the adjusted weights. And in the equation of a line, m is equal to w2 over w1, or minus w2 over w1. And b is the threshold over w1. And finally, we will print out the equation of the line. So y is equal to mx plus b. And then we call launch, which end up triggering a call to the start method, which will display the JavaFX window. And this will be the title, so let me rename this one. And we will have two types of data to display, have zeros and ones. So series 1 will contain data of type 0, and series 2 will contain data of type 1. And we will go through the training data. And if the target result is 0, then it will be in series 1. And if it is 1, then it will be in series 2. And we'll have 2 points on the line. So this is point 1, and this is point 2. So point 1 is where x is 0. This means that y will be equal to b. And point 2 is where y is equal to 0. This means that x will be equal to minus b over m. And we will define a title that contains the equation of the line and those two points on that line. And we will have x-axis and y-axis, and we'll define this scatter chart having those x-axis and y-axis. So it is between 0 and 4, both x and y-axis, and it increases by 1. And we set the title on that scatter chart, and we add series 1 and 2 to it. This way we can plot the end data point that we want to separate, and to plot the line we'll have series 3. Which will have those two points on it. And we will define a line chart. Along the x and y axis and add the series 3 to it. And we will instantiate a new pane. And add the scatter chart and the line chart to it. And finally, we will do a stage dot set scene and instantiate a new scene, and then show the stage. So this should do it for this class. Next, let's go ahead and test run this application. So we got this line that separates the zeros from the 1. So y is equal minus 2.47x plus 3.16. And if x is 0, then y is 3.16. And if y is 0, then x is 1.28. And let's take a look here. So we started from epoch 0, where the target result here was the same as the result except for this vector. And we went to epoch 4, where all the target result and the result are equal for all the vectors, and we discovered this equation of a line, y is equal minus 2.47x plus 3.16. So w1 is 0.32 and w2 is 0.78.